into the parlor, there's a welcome there for you. And if your name is Timothy or Pat, so long as you come from Ireland, there's a welcome on our mat. If you come from the mountains of Mourne or Killarney's lakes, so blue, we'll see you a song, we'll make a fuss. Who of you are you, one of us? You're Irish, this is a place for you.
Will be a relaxing, enjoyable evening of Celtic culture at our semi-open-air St. Joe Magella Open-Air Performance Centre.
Thank you. Ah, begorra, said St. Patrick, looking down from heaven above. I wonder what they're doing in the place I used to love. He meant, of course, old Ireland, where he had so many friends, in the days when he was mortal, just like them. Sure, I think I'll go astore to see those folks once more, for it's 1500 years since seeing them. Me children must be grown, oh how the years have flown, and I sure do need to see them once again. Whistling boldly as he walked across the cloudy plain, his thoughts turned to those rowdy few that he'd soon see again. Those bonny boys of Wexford and Kitty of Coleraine, there'd be Danny Boy and Rosie of Tralee. Such singing and such dancing all the while down in the lane, the greatest crack of St. Patrick that would ever be. To be sure, said our St. Patrick, I know old Ireland well, but map in hand he traversed the land, for you never can quite tell what may be in store if you're lost on the moor and wind up down in hell. Down the rocky road he strode and came upon a crowd of angry, strange young fellows shouting long and loud. Halt, they cried, where do you go? Why do you wander here? St. Patrick spoke of finding friends and asked them, were they near? No way, said they, for many years the Irish have been gone, off to find a sunny clime in another place in another time. St. Patrick sat and thought a while, scratched his head and smiled, then there I'll go to find them all, me children in the wilds. Australia was the place to go to find the folks from long ago. They journeyed there years before to find their home on a distant shore. So he dusted off his breeches and sullied forth again to the wide brown land Australia far away. Across the vast blue oceans he sailed both night and day, and his happy heart went back across the years. The sun shone brighter than he'd seen the day he came ashore, clear skies of blue and bright red dirt. 'Tis Darwin, to be sure.
Hey, I diddly daddle dum diddly doodle daddle dum diddly doo, right diddly day day. I diddly daddle dum diddly doodle daddle dum diddly doo, right diddly day day. I diddly daddle dum diddly doodle daddle dum diddly doo, right diddly day day.
Well, St. Patrick looked things over and liked what he did see, a bunch of dancing Irish, happy to be free. "Ah, begorra," said St. Patrick, "although they're very kind, it's me friends I'm over here for, it's them that I must find." He journeyed south across the plains, dusty, hot and vast, and landed in the Alice, where he'd see his friends at last.
Thank you.
Growing weary of the heat, the dust and flies alike, St. Patrick tipped his battered cap to new friends he had found, and ventured forth to Brisbane town to see who he could find. At Miller's pub, sure they'll be, as they all like to dance. A jig may be, there they'll be, perhaps there'll be a chance.
Thank you.
no sign of Rosie of Tralee or Kitty of Coleraine, and those bonny boys of Wexford waiting down the lane. Danny Boy was sung of twice, but nowhere to be found, and after 40 whiskies, St. Patrick's head spun round. He waved goodbye to the bonny folk who helped him on his way, and had to admit, as out of the door he tripped, he had enjoyed his stay. The search for the Irish had been long, and it was looking as though they'd all long gone. There's a place up north with a Scottish name. It's not really Irish, but nearly the same. St. Patrick set off in search of the place where the Irish had gone without a trace. The rain thundered down as he entered the town, and he knew that his journey was ending. It was Cairns for the night he'd be spending. St. Patrick had been searching all o'er this great wide land, and to be sure, there were many who were apt to lend a hand. Patrick sadly shook his head, for now it was quite clear that Kitty, Rosie, Danny and the boys no longer were down here. It seems they had departed long before his journey started, and had packed their swag and left this earthly plain. St. Patrick's feet were weary, he had travelled miles and miles, but everywhere he travelled, he had met with many smiles. "There are Irish here in droves," he said, "and although me friends are gone, I know good folk are biding here, and the Irish will live on."
Thank you.
Thank you.
And welcome back to Ellie Henley. Ellie spent the year in Townsville, but she managed to come back and she's danced. So welcome back, Ellie. Items to get you into the spirit of Christmas, and for our City of Cairns Highland and Irish Dancers to mark the end of a very, very difficult kind of, and a different kind of year. Wow, we've made it. Our first performance in for 2020 was the celebration of St. Patrick's Day at Brothers Leagues Club. Then there was Zoom, a very different concept, and then we were back to the studio. Preparation for our production has given our students a goal to work towards. All our students from the youngest, aged just 4, to our mature age dancers have worked incredibly hard. Let's now take you on a sleigh ride to dance a Christmas polka and then to wish everyone a Merry Christmas. Let's celebrate Christmas.
Thank you. season, so there isn't any reason we can't dance the Christmas polka. Here's sleigh bells ringing, everybody's singing, dancing the Christmas polka. Christmas trees and holly makes everybody jolly, and love just fills the air. It's a wonderful world for a boy and a girl while dancing the Christmas polka.
above.